Okay, so let's get it started. So the sound will screen, I believe they are on, right? Just to double check. Good, shukran. Tamam. So today we have the final master session, which is master session number eight, covering unit 11. In this master session, at the beginning, I'll discuss unit 11. Answering some questions, doing some exercises, not it's in cover for the unit, answering mock questions. And at the end, I'll go over the mock question, the mock exams, the three mock exams I already uploaded for the LMS. So unit 11, we focused on this unit on two concepts, which is the product quality. We talk about verification, but we focused more on the testing at the end. So when we're talking about the quality, in your real life, you may say about something that it's good, and that's it. But there is no standard categories on why you say that product is good. For example, I'm asking you, you have a new cell phone, you said, how is your cell phone? So it's a good cell phone. This is the general customer can how they can answer. But when you ask someone who's really specifying in this area about the cell phones, they have a set of criteria. They have a set of factors. They're going to say, because of this, that, like it's like a checklist about how they're going to measure. They having a matrices if the cell phone has a good performance, how they measure it. For example, they leave it for to run from the when has a 100 charge until it's died, or how it's going to work when you turn on multiple application at the same time. So they know how they going to measure the good performance of a smartphone. فلما تيجي تقولي لك إن هذا جهاز ممتاز أداؤه عالي إحنا نجاوب بطريقتنا إن أداؤه عالي but we don't think about the detail كيف نختبر أداؤه العالي. So now since you are studying software engineering you need to know the standard how you gonna to say this is a good this is has a high quality this software has a high quality. So what are the factors that it's gonna to let you say this has a high quality software. So based on this, if you back to our materials, in real life for software engineering, if you search about it, you can find many different definitions, many standardizations about it. But in this course, we saw three, let's say categorization on how we're going to define the software quality factors. The first one, which is done by Michael and Cavana, they said that you're going to have a set of attributes and sub-attributes. And they said it's going to be correctness, reliability, efficiency, integrity, usability, maintainability. So those six. And they say other mores. Why they say other mores? Because for this one, exactly, I'm going to use the laser. For this one, they answering the question of how the requirement will affect those attributes. يعني لما ترجعوا إلى, I'm going to show you direct on the unit 11. Oh, sorry, I just saw it. Let me just bring a unit 11. I'll just give me a second. Okay, here it is. So when we go to unit 11, you see here, you have a set of question that is gonna to tell you how you're gonna to categorize or how gonna to requirements affect those factors. The factors here in this level, So we having different requirements, different type of operation, operational, revisions, and transitions. I'm not going to repeat them as they are in the slide in the details. But my point is those in the second layer, they are the defined by whom? By Mackel and Kavanagh. So those correctness, reliability, efficiency, those are the ones that you're going to see it here. So at the first slide, they list only six. But if you go with whatever you have in covering for units, we have 11 at the end. So we have five here, and then three that affected by a revision. And then we have another three affected by the transition. So at the end, we will have 11 attributes defined by Mackel and Kavanagh covered in your unit. And they said many others. طيب, if we are saying what are the attributes that it's covered by ISO, International Organization for Standardizations. So this organization actually focused on that they said we have a lot of concepts, we have different organization, people have a different definition, we will have to define something standard about any concept. For forest software equality, they define it as it has six categories as functional, reliability, usability, efficiency, maintainability, and portability. So this is what's defined by ISO. Later, we need to measure those factors. So for this course, instead of going with those, which is we having listed in the slide 11 of this, and we having here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 categories, they in the course, they're just focusing on the four attributes, which is the correctness, will integrity, maintainability, will usability, which is defined by Tom Glib. So they said, we need to now measure those factors. الآن هذول هم بدل ما أنا أركز على الـ 11, 6, أنا راح أختار فقط الأربع الأساسية. That I can say هم هذول التقسيم الأساسي. This is the main categories as it is. So I'm going to discuss how can I measure each of them. كيف أقيس الـ correctness؟ كيف أقيس الـ integrity؟ كيف أقيس الـ maintainability؟ And so on. So now, if before I'll go into details, oh, where am I? So before going on details, how I'm going to measure them, I'm going to emphasize a part that explained in the unit, which is when you're having what? A pair of software factors. إيش يعني a pair? يعني بدل ما نهم تقولي, I'm going to measure the correctness, and you'll be silent. خلاص, أنا راح أقيس correctness. It's nothing else is going to be affected. This is not correct. حقيقة هم, in many cases, they affect each other. As what we explained during the requirement. Now we're going to explain it in represented of factors. So في الحقيقة, software quality factors, هم مش جالسين يشتغلوا كل واحد لوحده. They are not independent. In some cases, actually, they are dependent. So one of the questions, I believe this is from Mark, explain how the implementation of higher integrity measure in a software system could potentially affect its efficiency. Provide an example to illustrate your point. Again, when we answering a social questions, we supposed to answer each part. The first part, explain how careful integrity will efficiency, they are potentially affect each other. A second part, asking you to giving an example of illustrated your point. I already give you an example when we talking about a requirement and something similar to it. متى يكون عند الانتجريتي والإفشنسي يتعارض مع بعضهم. Sometimes you need to treat one of those off. يعني تتخلى عن واحد بغرض أداء الثاني بطريقة أفضل. So integrity, you guarantee having a high secure system. I guarantee that it hasn't been changed by anyone. The efficiency related to many concepts, including the performance. أنه راح يكون أسرع. متى ممكن يكون اثنينهم يتعارضون؟ Can anyone think about an example? Can anyone think about an example about when the integrity gonna to affect the efficiency?
في security?
Exactly with what?
Not sure.
The efficiency إيش راح تكون؟ مثال عليها. إن أنا ما تقولي الأداء اللي حق اللابتوب تبعي كويس. The efficiency of my software is good. One of the criteria such as the performance. Exactly. Exactly. بالضبط سعدية. When we're talking about نفس المثال اللي تفضلتي فيه إنه هو لما تتكلم عن السكيورتي. Security with what? When you're having a security that it's gonna to affect. So if I have a system that you said I need to have it as a high integrity, which is required encryption of the data. لما أنا أكون مثلاً عندي في نظام البنك مثل ما تفضلت سعدية إن في نظام البنك you asking for the encryption. And at the end you said I need to have the application of the banks to be so fast. You cannot do both of them because the encryption is coming with a price. The encryption is going to take time. It is going to take a CPUs from your systems. So this is potentially will affect at the end سرعه or the efficiency of your applications. فالفكره هنا you're just thinking about examples. Another two bears. So اول two bears the integrity والefficiency. The second bear, usability with portability. Usability, how it's easy to use. Portability, I can move it from one PC to another. I already give you an example that I repeated several times. I'm just gonna to say it quickly. I'm not gonna to give you another example. المثال اللي ضربته أن الطلاب they can open their schedule clearly في البيس في اللابتوب. But when they open their schedule for cell phone, you treat it off the usability, لأنه راح يكون الجدول يصغر. طب, another example, I'm going to give you a real example of the real life I haven't faced it before. One time, my kids has an assignment in the school applications. So they having a part, I'm putting this example based on that experience. They have an exam. They need to drag and drop an answer from one location to another. So the teacher, when they define this one, they assume that the student will open it on a laptop or like, let's say, usually it's on a laptop. So when we're doing a drag and a drop for that specific framework in the madrasa, it was working fine. Like when they trying to do it in their iPad, it doesn't work. So here, they trading off the usability with the portability. يعني المدرسة لما جات عملت السؤال, more likely إن هي عملته هي تشتغل على جهازها. So she defined a drag and drop. لكن الطلاب لما أجوا يحلوا, لما يستخدموا الآيباد أو التليفون السمارت فون, they cannot do a drag and drop. So as a user friendly, it may be a user friendly when you're having it in the PC. Like you're treating it off when we use it in a mobile context or in an iPad context. So you need to think about how you're going to treat them off between portability and usability. طيب, in the context of a software quality factor, may there be a treating off? This is what I just explained. So الآن I just give you an example of two bears, integrity والefficiency, usability مع portability. إنهم جايين مع بعض. إيش اللي عملته الآن هنا؟ As usual, I always telling you, don't think about memorizing how the questions come. Try to answer, try to understand the concept. حاولوا أنكم تفهموا الفكرة, regardless of how the way of the questions come. فمثلا, another way of the questions can come for each of question one and question two. نفس هذا ولا question three حقيقة هو مش question three. هو another way of writing question one and writing question two. فمثلا في الـ question one بدل ما طريقة السؤال اللي شفناها قبل شوية I can say in a context of software quality factor, why may they be trading off between the integrity and the efficiency? Let me now again, as I always emphasize, I have a number one part, why it's may. So this is the first one. This is just explanation. So this is not gonna to be number one. Why it may be trading off between integrity and efficiency? Number one suggests a scenario to improving one could lead to providing one could lead to a decrease in another. بالضبط هذا السؤال هو نفسه سؤال number one. الآن think about it similar for question two, just replacing the integrity مع the efficiency مع the usability and portability. تمام؟ طيب السؤال الآن if you recall لما بلشنا هنا I tell you what's important. طيب حنا ليش نقول إن عندنا هذول الفاكتور عشان نقدر نقيسهم؟ لما أروح إلى خبير تليفونات وأقول له imagine or you go to any store, you tell me which cell phone is the best now. حنا بطريقتنا العادية we just answer يعني in general. طيب but for them they are supposed to have a way of measurement for each one. And if you're going to any specialized on a software engineering, yes, he said, is this software has a high quality or not? So they will doing some testing, measurements, but first they need to know how they're going to measure each of those. Before I go, as I told you, I'm not going to cover the rest. I'm going to cover the measurement. Can any of you, I just would like to see how much you remember from the class. How we can measure correctness with one word. Correctness is صحة. If you're just going to say one word. Or let's say two. Let's move back to where we are. Okay. Okay, so I haven't got an answer, so let me go ahead with it. Before that, I just put a symbol, multiple choice to answer from you. Which primary, you see now we are talking about primary. مين هذول البرايمري؟ هم هذول الأربعة. اللي ذكرناهم في السلايد اللي قبل ما راح ارجع لها factors measure by مين منهم measure by defects be a thousand line of code 1 2 3 or 4 defect be a thousand of code defects okay number 1 C which is the same answer هي الكوركتنس أمينة وسعدية في أحد ثاني؟ Okay, which is right. راح تكون الكوركتنس. طيب. What I did here, I trying to put it on a table, so it's going to be easy for you to remember it. So الكوركتنس, if we just going to say it with two words, we're going to say defect. Or it's just one word, we're thinking about a defect. الانتجريتي, If we just gonna to say one word, we get to remember أساس إن حنا نتذكرها رح نقول defect. أساس ال integrity إيش الكلمة اللي ممكن تكون مربوطة بال integrity؟ ال integrity يعني إنه هو ما تعرض إلى تغيير. No one changes. I can't guarantee that it's no one touch it. مين اللي ممكن يغير في ال safe لا safe it's not gonna to give you the word whose can exactly you can say secure but more correctly مثل ما قالت آية الاتاكس we can think about the attacks لما نتكلم عن الاتاكس هم اللي راح يأثروا في الانتجريتي طب المنتربلتي so defect attack ايش الكلمة اللي تختص بالمنتربلتي القدرة على الشينج during time. إيش اللي راح يكون during time؟ measuring what during time. I'm going to tell you. It's going to be change. How fast you can change. If I'm just going to say one word, I'm going to say change to remember it. Usability. This is it's going to be in more detail. So we're going to see how we're going to put it there. So for the correctness, we think about measuring a defect per thousand. Per thousand, thousand يعني K. عدد الديفكت اللي صارت في كل ألف سطر. This is about the correctness. فأنا راح أحسب كم ديفكت صارت في كل thousand. That is the correctness. الانتجريتي حقيقة أعم من is just this one. اللي if you recall هنا في الديفكت في الانتجريتي. الانتجريتي in the slide they defined a four ways of measuring integrity. أول طريقة هي اللي إلى الطريقة العامة اللي هي ال proportions of the attack produced for any normal user. يعني كم attack يعني أنا إذا عندي أول طريقة اللي هي اللي مذكورة هنا. If I have 100 bona fide user يعني user الطبيعيين اللي أنا أثق فيهم. Let's assume I have a one. كم attack صار من بينهم؟ من المية. If one happened, that means the proportions راح يكون one percentage. لكن in fact, we have two other ways اللي راح نشوفهم بالسؤال بعد شوية اللي جاي. When you have a sensitive system مثل البنوك اللي ما تنتظر, we are not waiting إلى لزين الأساك يصير, لازم نكون استباقيين to measure the integrity. There's a two ways we discuss. We're going to discuss it. With third way based on a log file. بناء على إيش اللوج فايل؟ اللوج فايل هو الملف that I save the history of it. يعني أنا عارف أن فاطمة it's already accessed the website on Wednesday from this time to this time. She did this and she did that. So this is the log file. It's including my accessing information as an example. Based on after a month, لما أجي أسجل معلومات everyone accessing my website, I can analyze it and then measure the integrity based on it. So those we having four ways to measure the integrity. هنا I just defined the one that is defined at the beginning. اللي هي when we thinking about the proportions of the attack. الاحتمالية إلى الأتاك بالنسبة إلى المستخدمين الـ normal users. الـ maintainability if I'm saying in using two words, here's three, two words and two, time to change. If we're just thinking about it to change. طيب الـ time to change, قديش أستهلك وقت علشان أنا أغير السيستم تبعي, this is the maintainability. هل هو سهل أني أصلحه؟ طيب who remember من الـ slide that الـ MTTC اللي هي maintenance time of to change, maintenance time to change, including what? كيف نحسبها؟ إيش الأشياء اللي راح تتضمنها؟ لما أقول أنا هذا هو الوقت اللي استغرق معايا software to maintain it out. There is some issue I need to fix it and it take from me 2 days to finish it. هذول 2 days I see it إن هي MTTC equal to 2 days usually including what including just the time of fix قديش أنا أخذ مني بس علشان أصلح المشكلة or including figure it out or including I'm going to show you again here it's including what including 4 things including analyzing of the problem, including designing of the modification, including the implementation change, including the testing. فعملية حساب قديش وقت أخذ مني علشان أني أصلح المشكلة تتضمن تحليل المشكلة اللي تحليل البوكس كيف صممت الحل لها كيف عملت له implementation وكيف اختبرته. So including how I analyze it, how I design the approach, how I implement it, and how I test it. So الوقت راح يتضمن هذه الأربعة stages altogether. The last part is usability, which is related to user interfaces. And for this one, we have a different way to measure it. One done by a user and one done by an expert. فطريقة كيف أنا راح أعمل الاختبار إلى قديش هو سهل؟ أما أنا أختبر الـ usability تكون بناءً على المستخدم or based on الـ expert شخص عندي مختص. لما ترجع هنا للسلايد you have two ways. Either you're gonna to use it involving the user هو اللي يروح dynamically testing it, choosing what it would like to check it out. Or I have an expert who has heuristic review. So already he knows what is supposed to measure for usability. مثلا إذا كان هو جالس يقيم usability of a banking application. The expert already knows that it's supposed to have a set of lists. It's supposed to be for usability. مثلا the color, where is the seeing the account is. مثلا if you opening the banking account, usually it doesn't show you the amount of your account directly. Show it hidden, and then if you click it out, you see it. So have all a list of what it's going to look like, how are you going to use it as an experience of using a banking application. مين اللي يعرف هالإكسبرت؟ فهو عنده زي القائمة كده ويبلش يختبر السهولة في النهاية. So those are two ways of testing the usability. Okay? In a case where the integrity is a great importance, an efficient kind of and a different kind of attack can be identified. How can it be useful to measure or estimate the quantities? الآن this is what I explained about the integrity. إحنا قلنا عندنا four ways to measure the integrity عشان نقيسها. في طريقة اللي هي الطريقة العامة, the portions of the attack. لكن بالنسبة إلى system اللي تكون مهمة بالنسبة لها to define the attack even before it's happened, such as in banking, there is different way to do it. What they are, they need to measure likelihood that an attack can giving of a giving type will occur within a giving time. إيش الفرق هنا between the traditional checking out, الشخص العادي لما يقول أنا الويب سايت تبعي حصل له attack, كم attack حصل؟ Okay, next time I'll try to figure it out. But based on, مثلا, في البنك, they have a set of criteria even before. They need to define the likelihood. Oh, this is not a highlight. They need to define the likelihood. They need to define what's the type of attack and for which time. For مثلا, they said the type of attack, مثلا, لما يكون عندنا attack a lot on service and it's gonna to be bottleneck in our service, the access of deny, إن هي يكون عندي attack, يحاول إنه يدخل الويب سايت تبعي بطريقة مش رسمية. So they trying to make my system busy, عشان يصير النظام تبعي busy, so no one else from my normal customer they can access it. I'm gonna to measure this type of attack within a month, within a week. So this is how they're going to do it. The second way to do it is likelihood that it's an attack of a given type in a نوع معينة, أنواع الأتاك كثيرة. فلما يكون النظام حساس, they really care about what is the type will be replayed. So how they can solve the issue, كيف يقدروا يصدوا لها before even it's happened. Okay? طيب, then later we in this slide we have a small part about the verification and validation, which is we already explained several times before. So so I'm not going to spend too much time on it. So when we're talking about validation, we assume does nothing that's assumed before, because we need to make sure ensure the output meet the customer need. لأن إيش فكرة الـ validation؟ it's going to give you a value. هذا هو صحيح اللي المستخدم طالب منه. However, in a verification, لا, we have an assumption that it's already correct, إنه هو صحيح. لكن what we need to ensure on it, we need to ensure the process of producing the output. يعني أنا مش جالس أتأكد إنه هو it's meeting the need or not. أنا أسيوم إنه هو صحيح. هذا هو اللي طالب منه. But when I need to make sure for a verification, ensuring the process of the product. What is meaning of a self-consistency? And provide an example. إيش يعني self-consistency؟ والآن بالنسبة إلى اللي تكلمنا عنهم الفاكتورز من قبل, we said in some cases you cannot say that is by itself it's a consistent. لكن when you have it in a context of other elements, we said it's not self-inconsistency. يعني ما راح يكون صحيح لما يكون في معطيات ثانية معه. There is an example. Okay, I need to just emphasize as usual that we have two parts. What is the meaning of the self-consistency? And they asking you for example. راح استخدم المثال ال easy for you اللي انتو درستوه مثلاً بال object oriented من قبل. If you defining an integer x by itself, it's correct. Like when you defined another x for any other type, such as a double, a long, you cannot do it. So this is not a self inconsistency. Another example, what we see it في ال software, that it, before giving an example, how you gonna to define it? The definition that is related to your contents في material, it's more likely happening with the system documentation, and which is not going to claim that the system are often made it. So in the documentation, I say something, when I'm going to development, I have something else. مثال, claim that are both high secure and able to transmit the data with encryption. This statement is itself inconsistency. ليش؟ في البداية I said it's high secure and I يكون security حقه عالي. Ability to transmit data without encryption. فواحدة منهم راح تكون مش صحيحة. يعني أنا في documentation, يعني نفترض what they saying here, that let's assume I have a documentation of my company. عندي شركة وعندها مجموعة من الملفات اللي توضح what is this system about. فأنا أقرأ الدوكيومنتيشن تبعهم, لقيت واحدة من المتطلبات, they said, أو من التوصيف for software, they said our software is has a high security. بعد كذا بلا 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 بلا, they have one sentence said transmission data without encryption. I asking myself, but that this statement is self inconsistency, and you cannot have both of them correct. تمام. Another example is that when you're saying, for example, the developer said to check the authentication of the bank for the user, the banking system, I'm going to use the biometrics. راح استخدم العلامات الحيوية وهي مثلا بصمة الصبع. لما يجي المبرمج أو اللي يعملوا الفرونت اند يعملوا اللوج ان يوزنج الباسورد, this is going to be self inconsistent, لان as a developer I guarantee I'm going to use the biometrics, and then in reality what I see في الابلكيشن they using the password, فهنا راح تكون self inconsistent. Question about the first part اللي هي covering the software quality factor وcover the verification and validation. We will have now testing at the end. في سؤال على the previous part? Okay, thank you. So now we will move to a testing. So for a testing, what I did here, if you go to back to your slide, you will see a lot of types. They saying a list of general categories. then they drop it down to the type of development, and then for each scope, they're having it for system testing. So let me show it to you here for the slide, and how are you creating a hierarchical for you? So when we move into testing, they divide it at the beginning to a four type of generic testing. العمليات أو تقسيم الأساسي how we get to test it, which is including the requirement testing, usability, with development, will regressions. So أربع categories عامة ما رح أغطيهم كلهم لأنه we need to answer the exercise about the codes. بس you need to understand each of those. فين موجودين هذول هم؟ عندنا requirement, usability, recursions. What we're going to go in detail with it here, development testing. لما ندخل على development testing, we have a different level of development testing. لما أبغى أقيس development, التطوير اللي حقي إلى البرنامج, أختبره. Either I'm going to use it as a unit testing, يعني راح أخذ كل جزء وأختبره by itself. So for example, I have, let's assume I defining a unit as a class. So I test the student class, and then I test the course class, and I test as a unit. وهذا ما غطيناه بال, هو هذا الجزء المحذوف عندكم بالunit, it's eliminated, so it's not covered the unit testing. But what you need to understand about the unit testing is a part of my system. I'm gonna to test it by itself. Later, we have another level of development testing, which is the integration testing. So here you said I have a unit A, and I have a unit B, which is can be class. And I have a unit C. I test them. This is work fine. This is work fine. This is work fine. This is how you do a unit testing. When you come to the integration system, you're going to ask yourself, how do the three going to work with each other? هل هم جالسين يشتغلوا مع بعض بطريقة صحيحة? So this is going to affect that you going to have a multi way of testing. In this example, I have three units, which is I can define it as a three classes. Let's assume I have then class and another class, you know, which is I can call it M, or it's called another name, N1 and two. And these other classes, I already tested them, they work fine. And I have another two classes, I test N1 by itself, it's work, N2 by itself, it's work. Those are the three classes invoking Jalsini Nadi method that's including in those two classes, here N1 and N2. So it's going to be a many ways to testing it, وراح يعطينا a different direction. For this way, for this reason, we have a combination selection approach. And on the basis of that, what I can do here, I can say I'm going to test the A with the M, and then the A with the N2. Also, I need to test the B with the N, and I need to test the B with the N2, and then I need to test the C, how it is going to work with the N and with the N2. So this is the combination. For this reason, we don't need to run all those ones. لأنها راح تاخذ a lot of time. So we having three approaches for the combination selection. That is under integration testing, which is under development testing. تمام? So this is the second level of a testing. A third level, المستوى الأولى راح أختبر الـ units by themselves. المستوى الثاني, second level, I have the units, I'm gonna to test them how they will work together, كيف يشتغل مع بعض. The last level هي system testing. A system testing, I'm testing it to the full system how it's gonna to work. So let me get back to the slide to see definition of a system testing to show you where am I. So this is a development testing, and we have a three level of testing. راح نشرحهم الآن مش كلهم. عفوا راح أشرح الintegration testing with an example. لكن before this يعني الآن keep your eyes and نحن now you will back to this level اللي هي الintegration systems. System testing units each unit by themselves. Integration a combinations of the class units how they gonna to work with each other. That we're going to go over it now. A system testing, in another hand, it's testing what a complete system. راح اختبر كل النظام كامل. ما راح اخذ just one unit. ما راح اشوف how to check how units work with another unit. لا, I'm going to test the complete system. علشان اختبر النظام كامل, I have how many ways to do this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. عندي 8 اختبارات, 8 tests to test how my complete system will work. I'm just going to say them quickly. Each of those, how, what does it mean? A user command, it's representing on how it's going to operate it. كيف جالسة تشتغل? الانترفيس والبروتوكول about the communication. مش about the user interface, مش about the usability, مش طريقة الاستخدام, no. About the communication, كيف السيستم تبعي, الكوميونيكيشن والبروتوكول تبعه. The startup and initialization, لما أبلش أشغل السوفتوير تبعي, does it work properly أول مرة أشغله؟ هل يشتغل بشكل صحيح ولا لا؟ The restart, if I turn off my software, or let's say my app, on the cell phone, لما أسكره وأرجع أفتحه, it's going to work properly ولا لا. The performance, how fast it is. The stress, if I guarantee that my application can handle 100 customer at the same time, راح أجرب أدخل 100 مستخدم, 100 student in the same, أو 100 user, sorry, in the same time, and see, can it work in stressed? إيش يعني in stressed? في الـ upper bound. لما أقول أنا أقول هي تحمل 100 user, راح أجربه مع 100 user. If I say it can handle 1,000 user, I'm going to stress it out with 1,000 students or 1,000 user. Security, I'm going to measure security factors. Well, acceptance is going to either which is related to usability, either by a user or by an expert. So this is about system testing. And we move back to integration systems. The integration system, as I just mentioned, it has a different selection approach, which is a minimal with balance with safety. Now from their name, إيش يعني minimal? راح أختبر أقل عدد ممكن من الاختبارات. أنا فقط راح أختبر بعضها. When I use the minimal, when I'm not expecting an error, أنا ما أتوقع أن يكون في أخطاء, فراح أقوم بأقل عدد من الاختبارات. So it's going to be a minimal, the minimum number of tests. The balance, something between testing everything and testing the minimum things. The safety, it's that you test all possibility. فأنا for safety, أنا راح أختبر جميع الحالات. So how we get to count or خلينا نقول calculate number of combination. يعني أنا هنا combination selection هذول هم ال approaches. لما يعطونا exercises, they may asking us to calculate how many combinations you will have. كم اختبار مختلف راح نحتاجه علشان نكمل safety. كم اختبار مختلف for the minimum and how many for the pounds. We have already a formula. We don't need to think about it from our knowledge just as an explanation. So if I having three classes, هذا نفس الexample. I'll try not to make it complex. Use it the same example. We have it for the slide. So we having three classes. Who is invoking جالسين ينادوا the drawing methods اللي موجودة في another three classes, which is the triangle, the circle, the line. طيب الآن لما أفكر بالcombination, I'm gonna to think about the A, testing with all, the B, testing with all, C, testing with all. So the formula is gonna to be N multiplied by N. What's the M represent? Represents الـ first layer of the unit. So هذول هم راح يكونوا units. In our example هم classes لأن we're talking about the object oriented. لكن if we make it a general بالنسبة إلى software, you can think about it as any unit. So the units في الليفل الأول هم M. The units in the second level are N. So a safe approach is going to test all possibility, sorry, it is going to be M multiple by N. طيب المينيمال اللي جالس يقول أنا راح أختبر أقل احتمالية it is going to be the maximum, مش المينيمال, the maximum بين الM والN. Why it's going to be the maximum? Because if I assume that I have also I have B, C, A, B, C, if I have a D also here, Hannah, I should test a D with any of those. It can be this one, or this one, or this one. So if this is 4, and this is a 3, a test is going to be 4 tests. 1, 2, 3, and then 4. So this is going to be minimal. The balance, on another hand, they said, we're going to select, we need to make sure one of the units on the top tested with everyone in the bottoms. And also, I need one of the bottoms, راح اختار anyone, which is going to test with everyone on the top. So if I'm testing now, the one on the bottoms, sorry, the one on the bottoms, which is a circle, with everyone, so I have 1, 2, 3 tests. And then I have A testing with every unit in the second level. So it's 1, 2, 3 tests. So total is supposed to be 6. However, we know that this test is the same one. هو نفس التست. سواء هو جاي from A to circle or from circle to A is the same one. So that's why we need to eliminate it one. So we put it as a minus one. So it's going to be M plus the N minus the one. So if you get a question now, I'm expecting you to help me answering this question. Give a 5 classes and different classes, each of which use the method sum implemented in 4 classes. So what is going to M equal to? M equal to 5. Which is using method sum, يعني جالسين يعملوا invoking الـ method اللي اسمها sum, that's developed in 4 classes. So in N, it is going to be 4. What I'm asking you now to do, all of which are subclasses of one parent classes, يعني هذول الأربعة أساساً كلهم من parent classes واحدة. We talk about this as polymorphisms before. Calculate how many tests that will require using the following approach. كيف راح نحسب السيفتي حقها? Anyone can help me? Based on formula that we just did. كيف راح نحسب السيفتي? كم راح تساوي? I have 5M and 4N. Exactly. It is going to be 20. طيب. المينيمال. كم راح تكون? عشان اختبر كل الحالات احتاج اعمل 20 اختبار 20 تست. المينيموم is going to be 5. لا المينيموم is going to take الماكسيموم between ال 5 لان احنا عندنا 5 و 4. مين الماكسيموم بينهم؟ راح اختار الاكبر which is 5. So المينيموم راح تكون 5. What about the balance? How much is will be the balance? ثمانية ممتاز. So the balance is going to be 8. So we need 20 tests for saved, 5 for minimum, and 8 for in balance. One of the question, possible question ممكن يجيكم, such as what's explained عندكم بالسلايد. When they said, Hina, when you're going to use the minimum, when you're going to use the balance, when you're going to use a safety, الآن based on our answer, if I'm asking you to select between safety will balance or between minimum will balance, which one of those خلينا الآن logically أنتوا بتتوقعوا يعني as our humanity decide usually actually راح نختاره لو أنتم بتتكلموا نفسكم كذا خلينا نقول informal way which one you gonna choose and why safety والminimum والbalance which one you gonna choose and why And this is an example or a questions coming in your slides, by the way. Okay, just tell me which one you think you're going to use or you prefer to use. If it's just up to you to select it randomly. مين راح تختاروا تعملوا save or minimum or balance? Save. Okay, balance. If you're deciding to use save, Amina, In this case, save, it is going to make sure that everything's work correct. Let's assume in this case, I just have 5 and 4. Let's assume if you have a 100 units and a 100 units, the number of tests, it will increase repeatedly. So for this reason, save, صحيح إنه هو, it's going to make sure that I test everything. Lakin it's going to cost a lot. It's going to take a lot of time. So actually, save is not the preferred one. Now we have a select between the minimum and balance. But do you see a big difference between them? And if I'm thinking about the difference between a save and a balance, there is a difference. يعني عندنا فرق 12, which is, يعني, it's not... A small number, especially if the number increases, راح يكون الفرق كبير. لكن when we think about the difference between the minimum and balance, it's not too much difference. It's just a 3. So even if it's increased, the 12, absolutely, it's a big difference when we compare it with the 3. So if I have a choice to test it a little bit more and make my testing more durable, I'm gonna choose the balance. How they explain it here, they said the M plus the N minus 1, اللي هي ميم, آخر واحدة, راح تكون ميم, the balance. It's not too much bigger than the maximum, which is the minimum. هذه هي المينيموم. مش كثير كبيرة, مش كثير فرق عليها. بناء على الإكزامبل تبعنا هنا, it's just the 3. So in this case, So a balanced approach may be as will be used to prefer a minimal approach. أنا رح اختار البالانس لأن that's not big difference وفي نفس الوقت تخليني my test it has a higher خلينا نقول الاختبار حقنا يكون أفضل. Okay. However, لكن لما أنا أجي أختار between save الM multiple by الN هي save approach is much bigger than the balance. فهنا لما انتقل من السيف الى البالانس is too big فرق كثير فانا هنا ما راح اختار السيف حتى لو كانت ان هي تعطيني اختبار افضل مثل ما تفضلت زميلتكم في البدايه فكرت بالسيف تمام so if the save approach were used to prefer and a balance approach the testing load could be increased dramatically راح يزيد بعدد كبير as what I just explained here if you having 100 and 100 it will be increased a lot I have a question, balance and minimal, to get as accurate results. It's not about, Muhammad, accurate results, as about a testing, you need to figure it out if there is any issue in your system. خليني أعطيك مثال. الآن أنتوا إن شاء الله جايين مشروع التخرج. بتعملوا, let's assume you're doing a website that is taking a user, username, والباسورد بعد كذا they can go to the website and they select one of the product put it on the cart حطوها في السلة so now you have a different unit you need to do the combinations طب في شخص يقول first I'm gonna to test ان اليوزر يدخل الباسورد غلط واليوزر نيم صحيح then I'm gonna to test اليوزر نيم correct والباسورد wrong or I'm gonna to select in the customer select a product that's not in an in inventory موجود انه هو صفر but it's showing the system so عدد الاختبارات اللي بتختبرها راح تكون كثيره فهي مش about accurate الصحة، هي about you make sure أن your system doesn't have any bugs. علشان أنا أتأكد أن ما في عندي ولا مشكلة في السيستم، صحيح أفضل أن أعمل safety أختبر جميع الاحتمالات، but this is impossible. Like I just explained one part. لما تيجي تفكروا طيب بالويب سايت تبعكم you need to think about a lot of combinations so you cannot test all of those cases. In fact, you need to mention something like this when you're doing a testing part for your final project, part two. لما تكتبوا في الريبورت part two and you're doing a testing section, you're supposed to define which approaches you used and you list all what are the testing you are doing there. So this is about integrity. Question لسه عليها ولا لا؟ بقينا measuring of the complexity. تمام. So now we will move to the measuring of the complexity, which is covering more about how we see if our system. We're going to cover two strategies: the black box and the white box. For example, here I'm just going to back. So you have two strategies, which is the black box and the white box. If I'm just saying it in one word for each of those, the black box, من اسمها, you imagine you don't know what's happened inside. إيش هي الimplementation, إيش التفاصيل, I don't know what it is. I just need to measure the output that is there. It is, يعني أنا راح أعمل testing على the output اللي يطلع. This is the black box. The white box, in another hand, where am I? The white box, in another hand, is looking for the detail of the coding. وهذا اللي راح نحل عليه example. بس قبل ما أروح إلى the white boxing measurement that is going to solve exercise on it, I have one part. I don't have it for the master session because we already covered it in the details في the slide. شرحته مرة بالتفصيل اللي هي partitioning. فأنا ما ضمنته في the master session. If you would like to, you can check it out the record of this class. شرحنا بالتفصيل. في the black box, this unit, we cover only one techniques in details, اللي هي partitioning. We have three techniques, partitioning, random, and error. Here we just explain them in general, but the things that you can get a question with a detail asking you to define examples about it, مين هو partitioning. So أنا عندي already a situation, an example اللي حلينا عليه بالتفصيل اللي هي مثلا I would like to get an information of the flight number with seat and so on. So I have a different combination. I would like to measure the output. I'm not going to cover everything. I'm going to partition my testing based on a set of rule that I'm going to select the extreme near, extreme near for each case, near extreme for each case and the center. ارجعوا الى المثال حقها. This is a very important exercise. Okay, again ما غطيته لانه مكتوب هنا بالديتيلز. You see how many slides there, شارحينه مره بطريقه تفصيليه and very clear. Okay, and you can imagine any cases similar to it. What we going to cover now, which is not covered by example في the slide, هي the white box, which is focusing on how you going to have a code and you going to measure the complexity of this code. So we have three general categories of complexity. The first one is the simplest one. I just take a look to line of code. كم عدد الأكواد تبعي? Because obviously, whenever a number of code increase, that means it's possibility of increasing the error. The second category, which is cyclomatic matrices, which is counting the number of paths. So, أنا لو كان البرنامج تبعي, it has read from the user a number. If the number of the user is bigger than 10, print it out. So, how many paths I have now? Can anyone tell me? A very simple code. I'm going to read from the user and number. I have if statement to test if the user enter let's assume a positive number. كم باف عندي؟ كم احتمالية إلى الكود إنه يأخذها؟ Anyone else? إيش الأن؟ تمثل هنا محمد، إيش قصدك بالأن؟ الباث الفكرة منها في السيكلوماتيك. I'm back to the slide because this is a very important one. الباث that mean based on my explanation, I just have a code that I'm gonna to read from the user. رح أقرأ من عند المستخدم فقط قراءة. تمام؟ Then I'm gonna to enter to the if statement. رح أتأكد هل هو positive ولا negative. بعد ما أقرأ منه إنه هو positive ولا negative، إذا كان positive راح أطبع الجملة وينتهي البرنامج. لو كان negative راح أطلع من البرنامج. So how many direction البرنامج تبعي ممكن يمشي فيها؟ أول direction I start normally. دخلت على ال if I find it is bigger than أو it's a positive. أنا مجنة to print في statement وراح أطلع. هذا هو الدايركشن الأول. طب الدايركشن الثاني the second direction I go to the if statement I see the condition اللي هي the expression the boolean is it bigger it's a positive no it's not a positive so I'm gonna to get out of my methods so this is the second direction. So كم direction راح يكون عندي؟ اثنين. تمام؟ كيف راح نحسبها؟ راح نحل عليها example now. So this is cyclomatic. عشان تذكروها cyclomatic it's about the path. The third categories or third way to measure it is rely on the object-oriented complexity. إيش يعني object-oriented? If I have a class of students, I'm gonna to create student one, I'm gonna to creating a student two, and so on and so forth. هذول students they can do a couple of things, such as if a student class has a method, they're gonna to use those methods. طيب إيش كمان ممكن يكون؟ It can be student has a as an aggregation has a what? An address. So ممكن إنه هو يكون عنده عنوان. So I have an object with a type address. الفكرة من ال object-oriented complexity, you're gonna to ask yourself, now I have object students. How much object students are connected with other objects? كم مرة عنده علاقة مع ال object الثاني, سواء as an address, أو ممكن as a string, or ممكن as an exception. هذول ال student وال address, I creating them. لكن in fact, في ال object oriented, there are some classes that already موجودة في الجافا such as the math, the string, the array list, the exceptions. هذول كلاسات already there بالجافا. When I would like to use them, I'm creating the object from them. So if my object, لو أنا الobject تبعي, using any of them, I'm counting as a relationships with their objects. هذا اللي الآن راح نشرحه هنا. So how many types we have? We have a six. So let's get it started. A line of code is the easiest one. You're gonna to count number of line of piece of coded because more line implicates more error. So how many lines do you have here? I need your interaction in this part. This is a very important part, guys. Seven, good. Why seven? Someone may say six because they not to count curly brackets. The line of code, you're gonna to count every piece of line, even if it's just including a curly brackets. So yes, it's gonna to be seven. طيب, another important categories, الثانية, اللي هي cyclomatic, اللي لسه أنا شرحتها. When we gonna to go with a different direction, هذه هي cyclomatic. طيب, only الاف هي اللي تعطينا different direction. الاف راح تعطينا extra direction, يعني normal direction. أنا لو I have a code that it doesn't have any loop, راح يمشي بطريقة واحدة and that's it. So it's how many path it has, only one. If I have the F, it is going to add one more. طيب, not only F, it's going to adding me an addition direction, addition path. ليش أنا قاعدة أعمل emphasis على كلمة addition? Because any methods of the body, if it doesn't have any of those here, حتى لو ما فيها ولا واحدة من هذولا, at the beginning it's going to start with one. ليش? Because it's the default direction. لو عندي methods, it's going to read from the user and it's going to print it out. So this is one path. حتى لو ما فيها ولا واحدة من هذول ال other cyclomatics complexity keywords. So what other keywords going to bring is cyclomatics? The F, the loop, it is going to give it. So I'm going to count one. I'm going to count one for every loop. I'm going to count one مش for every switch. Please listen to this carefully. I'm going to count one for every cases, non-default cases, مش for every switch. So أنا لو كان عندي switch, it has three cases, I'm going to count it as a three. If I have one switch, have five cases, it's going to be five. Later, I have a try and catch. Again, هنا كمان أبغاكم تسمعوني كويس. I'm not going to count the try. I'm going to count the catch. So if I have one try, which is have two catch, I'm going to count it as two. And I'm going to count one for every and for every or. So let's try to doing this example. So what's the cyclomatics for this code? Okay. Anyone else? Any another answer? Three. So you all agree that that's a three. So كيف تبدأوا بالحساب في cyclomatic? Always you said I have one, which is the starting of the method. Then I have a while. I have integer. هذه ما راح تعطيني شيء. I have a while, so this is one. Invoking another method is not going to add anything. If a statement, so this is one. The break is not going to add anything. The plus is not going to add anything. The curl brackets is not going to add anything. So at the end, I have one, two, three. How are you going to write them in the exam? I just put it like this just for demonstration now. But for the exam, you need to say it. رح نشوف بعد شوية طريقة الكتابة الصحيحة في الإكزام. You're supposed to say the start of the method is equal to one. While one, the F is one. You have to write the details, okay? The object-oriented complexity, the depth of the inheritance of a tree, this is a very clear one. Thus, you need to measure a number of level of the inheritance. كم level من the inheritance? Starting from, it's existing between the class اللي أنا جالس أقيسه and the root of the inheritance. فمثلاً, لو عندي class وعنده ثلاث آباء, DIT, it's going to be equal to 3. So let's take a look to this example. If I'm asking you now, what's the depth of inheritance? I'm going to asking you based on the classes. The cyclomatic, it can a cyclomatic. You can asking you about the math, about the method or about the class. If we asking you about the method, you're going to calculate it for a method as what I explained here. If we asking you to calculate the cyclomatic for the class, cyclomatic for the class is the sum of all methods. يعني لو أنا عندي two methods, راح أحسب cyclomatic for method one, cyclomatic for method two is going to be cyclomatic for the class. When we're talking now about the object-oriented, for example, the depth of inheritance is calculating it for the class, مش for the methods. So I have the question said, calculate DIT, depth of inheritance of the bulldog class. I'm going to go to this code. I'm going to say this is a bulldog's class. What's the DIT? I wish you are opening the slide using a laptop, because if you are opening in a small screen, this wouldn't be that much clear. مين يقدر يقول لي كم الدي اي تي؟ اوكي اني انا اقدر انسب منار غير منار اوكي اي 1 هوز اولس اوكي So how we what we said between our class اللي هي البولدوجز and the roots. خلينا نشوف هذا هو البولدوجز. أول أبلو the first inheritance is gonna to be dog. So this is one. Then the dog extend from who? The mammals. So this is two. The mammal extend from what? From the animal. So this is a three. So how many do you have? Three. You don't count the based one between. So you said you have a dog, mammals, and the animals. So a DIT is going to be three. Okay. So why we don't calculate it? Either you're going to say it's the between. You're going to calculate the number of parents, or you're going to say it in this way. You're gonna to say, I'm gonna to calculate the roots, so this is zero, and then the mammal, and the dog, and then my class. لو تفكر فيها just logically, بعيدا عن الكلام explaining هنا, you ask yourself, the DIT, how many parents it has? It has one, two, three. Okay? So you count it, it's gonna to be as a three, which is animal, mammal, with dogs. This is the one we're going to spend some time on. It. And this is a very common question, actually. اللي هي CBO. إيش هي CBO? Coupling between the object. So my focus now on the object. إيش يعني coupling between the object? علاقة الobject مع بعضهم. That's the example I provided before. So if I have one student as an object, student طالب, الطالبة فاطمة, Inside it, it has a name with a type string. So this is one coupling. إذا كان عندها اسمها من نوع string, this is one coupling. If it has an address, using it, sorry. If it has an address, use it في methods later. This is going to be another coupling and so on. طب كيف راح نحسبها? We're going to calculate it. There is a different concept. I try to make it in a list هنا. When we gonna to calculate, add one more coupling between object. When you see a method call, يعني لما أشوف method اسمها whatever, it's called, I'm gonna to call it F, which is gonna to take an object with any type, such as مثلا string. تمام? So string, it's I'm gonna to creating object من نوع string. String, I don't define it, بس موجود بالجافا. So أنا هنا عندي object, هذا الاسم عبارة عن object. So when I have a method that it's called using string, راح أحسبها واحد. The variable access, when you're trying to access any variable of a string, so you're saying string equal to something. Inheritance, when one object inherits from another, the methods argument, the calling if you invoke it. So you're having an object, اسمه student one الطالب الأول and it's invoking the method. The method argument when you use it even as an argument. مش فقط إنه you use it so the argument when it's there. The invoking, the calling when you're using the invoking in this way. The return type. Let's assume this method اللي هي اسمها f. It's returning an object with a type string. We can count it also. If you don't get it, don't worry. راح نشوفها بالexample. So I'm gonna to make this bigger to answer it. So what is a cyclomatic, a coupling between the object for what? إيش جلسين نفكر الآن؟ ما قلنا methods. I'm talking about the customer class. So let me just make this bigger. So this is my code. Where is the first things I need it? I'm going to highlight it. What they asking for me to calculate the CBO for it, which is the customer class. So I have a shopping cart. which is have attributes array list, has a method, has a method, and then I have a class of item, and then I have a class of customer. So this is my class, which is a customer. I would like you now to think about this is a very important to understand, guys. So I need your help interacting with me. What's the output of this code? What's a CBO for this class? كم راح تكون؟ زبط. I'm going to give you a few more seconds to count it. أنا عارفة أن هي راح تحتاج وقت. Okay, two. I said two. Anyone else? Coupling between objects. كم راح تساوي؟ تمام. ثلاثة من يزود. Who's else? I really appreciate your engagements, guys. Okay. تمام. We have two, we have three, we have four. Okay, so let's now providing the answer. So let me just get this back to the normal size. So actually, it's a three. So who's get the right answer? Yay, Manar. Okay, so why is it three? You go to the customer. So it's depending on which object. You take a look, you figure it out, you have a string. So this is one. Okay. Then, ليش string حسبناها؟ لأن string حقيقة هي class بالجافا. So we are creating an object with a type string. So this is one coupling. And then I'm creating object from shopping cart. So this is two. Now, if you faced it is still. So those are the attributes. I have then three methods. I'm gonna to go over all of the methods. But the point is, if you're seeing the same type of object, you are not going to count it again. So if you see another string, ما راح نحسبها. If you see another shopping cart, we are not going to count it. So I go to this, it's using string as an argument. اللي حنا أساسا ذكرناها هنا, we're going to calculate it. But I'm not going to count it again because I already did. And then, I have, this is just assignment. I'm creating a new cart. So let me use just على أساس أني تفرقوا in case أن هي ما كانت هي نفسها. What I'm calculating cyclomatic for هي the customer. So this is the class. طيب. And then the first object here is string. Where I find the string, this is one. I find it later here, but I'm not going to count it, okay? What I find also, I find shopping cart object. I find it here again, creating a new shopping cart. لو ما كانت موجودة هنا, I'm going to count it down. But already is there. But yeah, what also I figured, I cannot use blue, it's going to do this, Sam. Okay. So I go down, this is void, ما راح يرجع any type of object. What's the argument is going to take? It's going to take an item. So an item is another type of an object. Adding an item is going to be similar, so I'm not going to count it down. And I have an item again, I already counted down. So at the end, I have a three, which is shopping, items, and string. You see how it is? Inshallah, the next one you're going to be answered correctly, and I have a shopping cart. So this is how you're supposed to answer it for the exam. You're supposed to say from where each is coming. The second complexity matrices, which is the number of children. A number of children, that's a number of immediate subclasses. So a degree of an inheritance, another name of it. This is, inshallah, it's not a hard one. So if I'm asking you about an NOC, which is the number of child of shape classes, where is a shape classes? Basically, how many child does it has? كم راح يكون الجواب? Okay. Yes. So how many child it has? A three. Circle, rectangle, well, rectangle. Each one I see after it's extend, extend, extend. هذا هما الشايل تبعها. Okay, so it's gonna to be three. The object complexity response for class RFC. What does response for class mean? Measure the number of methods, عدد method that it can be potentially executed in a response of a message received by an object of a particular class. In another way, if I creating an object of a student, from a class student, it has attributes and it has a methods. Those methods can be invoked by, so مثلا, one of the methods added course. I can say this one that added course. So I'm gonna to count it as one. So here a number of methods that can be invoked. كم method يقدر هذا الاس1 يعمل لها invoke? So مثلا هنا, I have a calculator class. This is the calculator. Inside the main, if I'm creating objects, هذا الكالكوليتر هو object. من أي نوع, from which type, from the calculators. How many possible methods can a calculator invoke based on this example? كم method يمدينا هو يناديها? Four, exactly. It is gonna to be four. So how I calculated this for, how I calculate the RFC, I said, the calculator can invoke the add, can invoke subtract, can invoke the multiply, and it can invoke divide. So those all the method, it's possible for an object, a calculator to invoke. Now we will see more examples, the line of code, I'll show you the answer right away. So how much is the line of code of this one? Okay, 999. Okay, so exactly, it's gonna to be 9. So you're calculating everything, including the curly brackets, is 9. I'm not gonna spend time on it. Okay, another exercise is the RFC, all the methods in the class, or the ones that the object is actually invoked. Not actually invoked, the methods can invoke. Sometimes you have a methods, usually any methods in the class, for our cases now, yes, any methods in the class. So the first part, all the methods in the class, not as actually invoked. This is example coming from the mock exercises, اللي موجود عندكم بالاختبار. So what does this include? It's including class, a thicker class, and it's including a sorter class. Each of those has a method. A thicker class has a method, اسمها thicker, and the sorted class, it has a method called create and sort. So the create and sort is starting from here, and end with how many curly open brackets I have, 1, 2, 3, and this is the end of it. So this is the end of my methods, and this is for the first methods as well. It is the end, I'm using the highlights, yes. This is the end of a thicker, and if I'm looking for an end of a class, this is going to be an end of the first class, and this is the end of the second class. Am I right? So how many open curly brackets do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Exactly. So this is how it's going to go. طيب الآن the questions, you need to be careful if they're asking you to calculate for the class or for the methods. خلينا نبدأ فيها بالسؤال الأول. Calculate the following matrices important to show how each value is calculated. لازم تراوي الخطوات. The cyclomatic for a thicker method and the coupling between the object for the class. So if I'm using the same color for the methods, اللي هي اليلو, راح نحسب لها cyclomatic. Cyclomatic different path. اللي نحسب فيها ال if والwhile والand. هذه cyclomatic. بالنسبة إلى الكلاس, we're going to calculate the CBO. So let's start first. I'm not sure. Yes, this is, let's make it bigger. So my focus at the beginning, fusing, I'm going to calculate cyclomatic for the methods, اللي هي الثكر. كم راح تكون؟ Cyclomatic. How much is going to be cyclomatic for this one? Cyclomatic, different path. Which is has if, while, try and catch, switch, and, or, all of those is different path. تمام, ثلاثة. طب خلينا نبدأ. أول شيء, always, when you start, you have one. So, let me write it down here. So I have one for the method. And then I go, I read them one by one. Do I have a bath here? No. I have a try. I don't count the try. I count the catch. I have if or la, abadan. Do I have a double? I go to them one by one. I have a while. So this is another one. So I have two so far. And they have a print. Doesn't gonna to change anything. I have a catch. Sorry, so this is one as well. So at the end, I have how much? I have three. Yes, صحيح. Cyclomatic حق الثكر راح يكون three. طيب, the coupling between the objects for the class. الآن, I would like to calculate the coupling between the object إلى the class. How much? The coupling. يعني راح أبلش أمشي على الكلاس تبعي. I'm looking for objects. أبحث عن الأوبجكتس اللي موجودين. Can anyone figure it out? كم راح يكون الـ CBO? Okay. Five. ممتاز. Okay. Yes, it's going to be five. So let's now see why it's five. So you go here. You see what? You're creating a file, so you're having one for a file. You're creating printer writer object, so this is one as well. So this is a two. And then we're using the math, so this is a one. The math, we're having an object there. And then, do I have any object here? I have an exception. So this is now a math. What is the fifth? You said five. I and تعدية. مين الخامس? Who's the fifth? We said whenever I have an object, exactly, a system. A system, when you say system, that out, that print, this is representing an object. So I have a file. I have a print writer, هي class, وجالس أنشأ منها object. And I have a math, I have an exception, and I have a system. كل هذا لا راح يكون object, okay? طيب, the same things. الآن, let's do it for let me erase everything. راح نحسب كمان نفس الشغلة بالنسبة إلى السورتر كلاس. كم CBO حقها؟ الكابلينج between the object for السورتر كلاس. كم راح تكون؟ Anyone? I'm not sure if I have it here as a question. Here is how you're going to supposed to write it down for the exam. يعني لو إجاكم شغلة زي كذا, you suppose we just answer it in the code, but this is how you're supposed to write it down. Yes, so we still have the question about the sorter. So, كم راح تكون الـ coupling? My question now, I start with the coupling between an object for a sorter. كم راح تكون? You said two. Anyone else? مين اللي تقول two? آية. طيب غيرها. أنا جالسة أحسب الـ coupling between the object. إلى مين؟ إلى الكلاس هذا كله كامل. كم object تشوفوا داخلها؟ طيب مين التو؟ يا آية ويا أمينة. Where is the two objects? إيش هما؟ Let's do it together until you're writing the answer. The int math. The int is not an object. The int, إذا أنتوا متذكرين من ال object oriented, إحنا عندنا نوعين من ال data. معلش بس ريفيو إلى ال object oriented لأن هذا مهم بالنسبة لنا هنا. Let me review it quickly with you. الآن في الميموري في ال when you're writing في ال object oriented, we have two type of data. We have primitive and references. إيش يعني primitive? When I say int x تساوي الخمسة في الميموري, I have the x exactly which is, has 5 inside it. This is the primitive. ما هي جاية من any class. ما أقدر أقول مثلاً x و I invoke any methods. هذا راح يكون خطأ. مش references. This is, you don't count it as an object. However, when you say string, I'm supposed to pick my pen, is equal to, you creating object اسمها s, which is references, يأشر على مكان, and it has a value. إيش اللي يمثل string؟ هي string هي عبارة عن classes. You have it for object oriented and you're creating objects منها. So we calculated. I see your point. You have array. You don't have array list. So, and thank you to make this mistake so you don't make it for exam. This is an array. The array is not a class for object oriented. The array is not a class. The array list is a class. So we don't calculate in this one as one object. Even if you see a word new here, هو جالس ينشأ صحيح a reference of it, لكن numbers, this is not an object of any class. The array is just an array with a certain type في Java, but not an object. We don't count it as an object for the array, okay? فلما تشوفوا كذا array, don't count it down. Array list, yes. So for now, what's the CBO that we have it? We don't calculate the array. We don't count the array. We have only math. So this is one. I go ahead. I don't have any other object. So في النهاية, كم راح يكون CBO for this class is just one, okay? We don't count the int. The int is not a reference. You count the object. The object any reference object. تابعة إلى class موجود بالجافا. Any primitive variable such as int x, double x, array, كلها ما راح تنحسب إن هي object. Okay? So at the end we have only one. طيب إيش عندنا كمان هنا؟ We have then calculate the cyclomatic for. Let me erase what I have. We need to calculate the cyclomatic for the create and the sort method. هذا هنا عندنا. كم راح يكون cyclomatic حقها؟ كم cyclomatic? Okay. For anyone else? I have Aya for, Sadia for, and I have another Aya Nasser, Khamsa. So let's see now. I go to the first line. At the beginning, whenever you start in the method, you count as one. So I have one. I go to the first line, it doesn't have any path. I have four, so this is one. And then I go to this line, it doesn't have anything. So I have a four, this is another one for this four. I have a four, this is one. I have F, this is one.
I have int equal to doesn't do anything, doesn't do anything, doesn't do anything. So how much do I have at the end? I have 1 for the methods and 3 for the for and 1 for the if. So at the end it's going to be 5. A common mistake, guys, you forget to calculate the first of starting the methods. هذا خطأ very common في الاختبار. إن الطلاب من العجلة والتوتر and I really understand it. That's why I really happy to having you here. لما تسمعوها once, two times وتعملوا practice عليها إن شاء الله ما تطيحوا بهذا الخطأ. You forget it. دائما المثل you will start with the one at the beginning. طيب. Based on a calculated matrices in the part one, briefly discuss which class will be considered to be more complex. And عندنا هنا class M, which is a thicker and sorter. حسبنا cyclomatic and coupling between the objects for each of those. For the first class, اللي هي thicker, I have as a 5. And for cyclomatic is a 3. But what's the point اللي أنا قلتها من قبل? Cyclomatic for this class is how much? It is going to be equal to cyclomatic إلى الميثود. ليش? What? Sorry, why? So the coupling between the object حسبناها. 5. لكن we didn't calculate a cyclomatic for a thicker. We calculated only for a method. لكن it's gonna to count as a 3. Why? ليش راح تكون cyclomatic مساوية إلى cyclomatic إلى methods of a thicker? أنا ما حسبنا cyclomatic إلى class. حسبنا cyclomatic إلى methods اللي هي thicker. وبعدها قلنا السايكلوماتيك إلى الكلاس تساوي السايكلوماتيك إلى الثيكر ميثودز. Why? Anyone? Because I only have one method. If I have another method, I'm gonna to calculate the cyclomatic for this, and for a second method, and I'm gonna to sum them up. نفس الشيء بالنسبة إلى sort classes. So based on the explanation, so I have cyclomatic as a 3 for the class, which is اللي هي كانت إلى methods, and I have the coupling between the objects as 5. For, let me erase all these inks, and for creating a sort class, cyclomatic is going to be 5, while coupling between the objects is 1. So based on this explanation, if you are thinking about which one is more complicated, it's depending if we are focusing on cyclomatic store classes, it's going to be more complex because it has a 5. And, you know, it has only 3. If we are thinking about it, the complexity measured for based on the coupling between objects, a thicker class is going to be more complex than sorted classes. Okay. If we have a multiple method, would we add there cyclomatic to get the cyclomatic complexity of class? This is exactly what I'm saying, Saadia. So if you have only method, one method, if the class has only one method, that's gonna to be the class cyclomatic equal to the method cyclomatic, and I have only one. If I have two methods, then the cyclomatic of the class is going to be sum of a two method. So I have a three method, sum of cyclomatic of the three methods, and so on and so forth. So, yep. Giving this following piece of code, calculate the cyclomatic for the creating the account. So let me highlight this. So I have the class LVIB, and then I have attributes. And then I have how many methods? I have a VBN account. خليني استخدم another highlighter. I have a VBN account methods, and I have the create account methods inside this. So this is exactly what we just discussed. And this is the two. الآن if I'm asking you about following calculate cyclomatic for creating the account. So what I'm thinking about, I'm supposing to using a red because it's there. طالبين مننا cyclomatic إلى هذا ال create. كم راح تكون؟ Cyclomatic يعني number of bath. So I have to answer 5 then 5 and it's correct. It's gonna to be 5. Cyclomatic. راح نبدأ في البداية في السايكلوماتيك راح نقول 1 then I have 4 2 I have F 2 1 I have another F راح تكون 1 and then I have the catch this is 1 so I end up with having 5. طيب the coupling between the objects how much is going to be 4 L VBN account class هذولا اللي جالس أحسب له the coupling between the objects how much is going to be the coupling between the objects 4 ممتاز why I have array list هذه 1 هنا I'm counting the array list so this is going to be 1 and then I'm using the member so this is 1 I'm using what also I go to so I having the array list I having the member I go for the 4 I don't have any object get I don't have an object can try add I have exception so this is 1 and I have a system this is 1 so I end up with having 4 cyclomatic for the classes I supposed to yani specify it it's for what exactly yep I know we are reaching the time but I believe we just having this two more exercises if you would like to leave you can leave if you have another class, we just have two more exercises. So calculating the cyclomatic and the coupling between the object for the following piece of code, show how each value it's was calculated. طب هنا في السؤال, they didn't mention the cyclomatic and the coupling between the object for what? So we're going to do it for the class. And in fact, when you're doing it for the counter method, here cyclomatic, it is going to be same because we already having one. So for cyclomatic, we will start with a cyclomatic one, which is using starting with a method. So I have one, and then I have a while. Oh, I already showing the answer. Sorry. And then we having a while. So this is one. I'm going to go down. I see F. So this is one. I go down, the closet doesn't count. I have a catch, so this is one as well. So we end up with having 4 cyclomatic. The next by the coupling between an object, I creating object min not file, so this is one. I have a string, so this is one. And then I have a buffer reader, have a class module already built Java, creating an object, so this is one. And then I have also, and don't get this out, you see, complete reading the full sentence. I have a new file reader. So I'm creating object command, من نوع file reader. So this is one as well. I go down, I في الوايل ما عندي any object. في الف, I don't have any object. Close, it doesn't have. Inside the catch, I have an exception. So this is one. And at the end, I have system. So في النهاية, we end up with a 6 CBO, the coupling between the objects. Last question, هذا آخر سؤال. So can anyone help me solve these questions? Calculate cyclomatic complexity for run method and the coupling between the object for the class. So خلينا نبدأ في البداية. So this is my class, اللي هي controller. What I have? I have a run method. So what I need to calculate now, cyclomatic for a run. كم راح تكون cyclomatic إلى run? كم سايكل كروماتيك إلى run and how much the coupling later. Let's finish the سايكل كروماتيك first. Okay. Three. طب أسير. في أحد ثاني. كم بتكون السايكل كروماتيك؟ سايكل كروماتيك يعني راح تكون الباث. So let's start doing it. You're starting at the beginning with one. Later, I have if statement. So هذه راح تكون واحد. But then, what do I have? I have and. So this is one. After an and, what do I have? Blade doesn't count. Else doesn't count. I have catch. So this is one. And I have another catch. This is one. And then what also I have? Do I have any other parts of it that I need to count as an above? Okay. Click. So I'm going to show the answer since no one is there. So I having the start is one. If is one and then the add is one, I supposed to remove this one. I have a catch two catch, so I have one plus one plus one. This is a three and two. It's gonna to be five. How much I'm gonna to have calculating CBO, coupling between the object. Whenever you're starting, you're creating object when not the player. So this is gonna to be one. Array of indices gonna to go here. I don't have any other objects to create, and I'm gonna to move out. I have array index out of boundary. This is another one. I have exception. An object with type exception is different than type of array index out of boundary exception. Have a class or have a class? So we're gonna to count this as one as well. So, and then we have the system, which is gonna to end up with four. Okay. So this is the last exercise. We're going to cover it for today. And any question about coupling, cyclomatic, this is a very important part. So if you have a question, I'm here for you.